Welcome to the diving pool for the 30th Summer Universiade. We have three more days of diving. I'm Chris Snowd, and our next event is the final of the men's 3-meter synchro competition. And there's the confirmed order. Indonesia will go first, followed by the Germans, Russians, Georgians, Italy, Japan, Korea, USA, and then Mexico. Fielding and Yost. The fifth, just missing out a medal in previous games. Fielding already had three competitions under his belt, just kept missing a medal. Inward to start. Yeah, good dive for the Americans. Let's see if they can get above the benchmark of 46.8 at the moment. Reaching up, open pipe position, locking out just about the same time. Very tight bodies going through the water. Fielding with a beautiful pipe there, faced right across the top of the legs in the open pipe. Yost also with a good inward dive. The Americans have got the highest score so far in the first round. Hu and Li out of China. Same dive. The Chinese perform it in the open pipe too. You can do it in three positions, open, touch your toes, or closed with your arms around the back of your knees. This will be open. Well, I have to say, I think that is better than the Americans. This could be the first dive over 50. I can't fault this. Distance is right. Synchronization. Yeah, I think it's there. Maybe, just maybe, Lee might be 1 centimeter out or even half a centimeter. But we're really getting picky here. Great inward dives for them. And they do. They're 50.4, the first team over 50. Has Garvey, third place, tied. Yes, it's good. And that crisp entry as well. The divers are looking for what's called a rip entry. That's where the hand goes flat, tears the water apart, sucks the water down so you see a little splash. Beautiful holding there, like that. But here, both of them get that feel on the hand, sucking the water through, and the judges closest to them will hear that rip sound. Very close to 50 points, 49-0. Japanese are on form. Hu and Li, China, current leaders. Any team to go over 50. First dive. Oh, missed it. Hu looked to jump a long way from the diving board. So that's a miss for the Chinese. Synchronization is off. Distance is out of sync. Completely wrong timing all the way across the board. 46-20. So they'll lose their first place. For the moment, at least. Well, the crowd favourite, home team, Italy. Not too bad at the moment, in fourth place. So with that 68 in the previous round, has kept them in fourth. Oh, good effort as well. I thought I saw a little bit of a wobble going around then from Casali, but doesn't matter when you get an entry like that. Good effort, good synchronization, lovely landing on the end diving board. Could have just hugged the shoulders around a little bit more on the double twist, but it's a good dive and they'll take that. Best score for them so far, 4 points better than previous round, 72.42. USA with that 70-pointer. in the last round, currently in second place. Well, wasn't first after the two easy rounds. Oh, Jost has lost it. Well, Jost landed on the corner of the diving board, hesitated, was going to stop, then went, had to change position from pike to tuck. So the maximum you can do get is a 2 points from the judges because the dive has been performed in the wrong position. And that's disastrous for the Americans who were up for a medal in this competition. And they're just explaining that you've got to keep on the end of the diving board. So two despondent Americans, head down, walk off. Russia. Well, it was going so well, and then Mikhailov pulls too hard on the entry and pulls his reverse 3.5 over. Great top, fast spin, coming around the triple, kicking out just a little too late. And Nikolov pulls his dive over. Let's have a take a look. Ultranov also slightly over, but with the better of the two dives. Well, Nikolov with 5.5, 5.5. Ultranov with 7.5, 7, 7.5, 69.30. Lee Anru of Korea, sixth place. We've had a couple of misses, so going to take up the advantage with the other teams dropping their dives that are ahead of them. Yeah, beautiful back 2.5s. And just at the right time, they're looking back, they want to see the scores, they know it's good. Very fast pull forwards, spinning fine, feeling good at this point. And this is the point, you know, as a diver, that if you just get the spot right, you're going to get great scores. And we're going to have to see a big score come up. And they're into the 70s for the first time. Definitely that's going to improve their position. Eights for the synchronization. China in the lead. Still two dives at 75. Going to make it a third on their 3.5 pike. Well, it's going to be near impossible to beat these Chinese team. They're not putting a foot wrong. 3.5 pike. There's the throw. Classic spin, synchronization. Well, I can't fault it at all. See a small position break there with Hugh. Just a little untidy with the pike. But 75.33 for a third time in a row. Russia are in for a medal. The current champions since 2011. Different teams. And they catch the Chinese with this dive. Well, it's a good final dive for the Russians. It's good enough for silver. I doubt whether it's going to be good enough for gold. If it is a silver, then that will be their fourth medal of the competition, second silver. But it's not over till it's over. They'll be pleased with the 72 points. They'll be disappointed that they let it get away. One dive, two dives in the 60s, two dives in the 70s. So it will be a medal for Russia, but we don't know what color yet. Likely to be silver. So congratulations, lads. You put in a good job. Italy have had a blinding competition, currently in third place. This is everything they've got to get for at least a bronze medal. Inward 2.5 somersaults pike. Well, it's good and it's steady. Cheers from the crowd. They know it's going to be close. Can Italy pick up a second medal at the championships? Very high finish. Good lockout from both of them. 69.30. Consali looks happy. Porco, if you turn around, is there a smile? Maybe. Lee and Ru of Korea. Well, they have a chance. They have to go above 3.62. That's the score of the Italians. And they're on 2.91. They will need 73 points. It's a good dive, but I'm not sure it's going to hit 73 points. Will this confirm a medal for Italy, or is it a medal for Korea? Well, they're trying hard here, squeezing, pulling in, locking out. I just don't think it's high enough for one. And it isn't. 63 points for the Koreans. So that puts them behind the Italians, because they're only on 3.55. But here on the diving board, surely are the champions that we're going to be crowned after this forward 2.5 somersaults double twist. Well, they've nailed the entry, and they know it. You can tell the way they're swimming up that they've got the gold medal. They're sure of it. They had a huge lead. And after the Americans failed their dive, it was down to the Russians to catch the Chinese, and they couldn't do it. So China finished with a near-perfect score and the high score of the competition, 80.58, with a huge score over 400 points, with 403.71. And China take their seventh gold medal of the competition, with a huge lead of 30 points over Russia. Russia have been the champions for 8 years, and it's now China's turn, 3.73. Italy, what a great result in front of a home crowd. They held it together under huge pressure from Korea. Third for the Italians, bronze medal for them, which is their second medal of the championships. So we are at the diving pool for the final competition of the day. And there's the lineup. Australia gonna go first. Second, Russia. Third, Mexico. Fourth, Korea. And fifth, China. Cho, already with a silver medal in the bag. Yeah, good reverse dives from both of them. The right distance from the board, so they're standing facing the water, but having to jump away and then rotate back towards the board. It's safe, good touches. The same style have come out as well, around in front of the face. Good lockout on the knees in the pike. So should score well on the synchronization. Entry is pretty good. And it's the highest score so far, 47.40. for the Koreans. And final divers in this first round, Gao and Wu. China have won this competition 6 times, but the last time was back in 2013. First dive, back dive pike position. Oh, that's the best entry so far, disappearing through, getting that tearing rip sound that the judges are looking for. So highest at this point is 47 from the Koreans. I think this is better. So will they get closer to 50 points? There's the float through. A little different timing on the reach back there. They've gone into the 50, 52.20. So 8.5 and 8s for the execution, 9s for the synchronization. Russia currently in third. Reverse dive pike. Yeah, good dives. Right down to the bottom, 5 meters to the bottom of the pool. Quickly up to look back to see the scores. Good synchronization, lovely pike, good extension of the knees. Leaving the ball together. What a sight that is against the blue sky. And there's the tight lineup. Well, the Russian's looking quite strong. 46.20. Improves on their first round score. Mexico in fourth, a chance to go ahead of the Russians, who were in second. Same dive. But Estrella looked like she was struggling to get into the pike there and dropped short. Wonder if her legs or her hands slipped a little bit. So it was a very open pike for her. Diving here on the right. The throw is good, but just there, out too early. Now the pike is okay. Well, is it? Well, that is a miss. Zambriano of the better dives. But still 10 points up on the Russians. So that moves them into first place for the moment. Russia still have a chance back in fourth. Back 3.5 somersaults tuck, 3-3. Stepping over, kick too late, and we're right over onto her stomach. Oh, that's disastrous. Russians were in second place, and they look a little winded as well. Strapping over, diving on the left here, kicks feet up, and goes right over onto her stomach. Teammate Silvanovsky also over, but not quite as much. Would you believe it, 37.62 for the Russian pair that were having a chance of a silver medal. So it's wide open now. And Mexico second on 150. We're going to do an inward 3.5. Down 0.1 at 3.2. Yeah, that's good enough. Estrella and Zambrano kicking out at the same time. Zambrano is shaking her head. I don't think it looked too bad. Estrella pulling the knees apart to increase the rotation. But with all the other divers missing, they'll take every single score that they can get or squeeze out the judges. 65, it's good. Korea in third. On 1-4-3. Oh, they pulled the dive around. I thought Cho was going to go short, but she pulled just at the right time. So the jump off the platform's good. Just a little bit stuck or slow spinning there. Better the dive from Moon here on the right-hand side. But Choi did the right thing, pulls the dive around, 66.99. So that keeps them in second place in medal contention with the Chinese still to go. Good synchronization scores there. China, inward 3.5 somersaults, 170, 20-point lead going into this round. Joe and Luke. It's low finishing, but good going through the water. So they're having no problem whatsoever, the Chinese. Bar any something disastrous happening, the gold will go to them. Look at that. Very sharp on the kick, fast off the ball. Synchronization is good at this point. Both splitting their knees at the same time. Oh, we'll accept that. 71 points. So that's the highest score of the competition so far. And that will increase their lead over teams. So after four rounds, China have increased their lead yet again with 2-4-1. Mexico have a 6-point lead over Korea, who have a huge near 30-point lead over the Australians, and the Russians are back in fifth. Well, what a chance for Mexico. Currently second, have been steady all the way through, haven't really missed. Well, they're out of sync, but guys were good. 2.5 somersaults, one twist. Surely this is going to be good enough for a medal for Mexico. Just one of four nations that have got a gold medal in this event, but that was 12 years ago. But they still are second in the leaderboard over the all-time 18 years that this competition has been in existence. So 60.03 will give them a medal, but we're not sure what colour yet. Final score 276. So that's what the Koreans will need to get past if they want to get a silver. They're currently in third place. Score 210. They need 66 points. Well, it's good. If they go 66, 67 points, they might go ahead of the Mexicans, who are sitting at the moment in second place. It is going to be quite close. Good final dive from the Koreans. Strong off the platform. They've really gone for it. Locking out. Yeah, good spot on the end there. But it's not over yet. We've seen leaders before crash out, but the Chinese have such a massive lead, already on 241 points. Only need 35 points to take gold. And that's going to score way more than 31 points. So China have done enough to win by a massive score. The last time that they won this competition was back in 2013, and this will be their seventh gold since 2001, the first time that this competition was added to the championships. There it is, confirmed. 64 points gives them 305, the only team to go over 305. China take gold yet again at this competition. That makes it 8 golds out of 9. Only Mexico has the other gold medal. An amazing performance from the Chinese. Korea come back for 272. So gold, silver, and bronze is confirmed.